What?
I did not realize that my mic was off. Hello everyone and welcome. Hello Crazy Animator. Sorry about that. Yes, long time no see. For some reason I did not turn my mic on. Long story short, last week we played Diablo on live streams. I try to stream every Friday at around 5 p.m. Pacific. I'm a little late, but it's okay, that's why I say around. We were playing Super Mario 3D World the week before that, as well as Paper Mario. As far as Super Mario 3D World goes, Double D, I'm gonna probably have to wait till Double D or my wife is available to play that with me, just so we can knock out those extra levels quickly. So until then, I don't know if I'm gonna actually be playing Super Mario 3D World much. So instead, we're gonna move on to New Super Mario Bros. U, which is the other exclusive Super Mario game for the Wii U. Okay, I'm gonna skip this real quick. Okay. Looks like I'm gonna have to delete a game. That one looks like a good one to delete. Okay. So I will be playing with the Wii Pro Controller, which was not in the original release, believe it or not. This one is also one in which you can play with the multiplayer. And I'm stuck as Mario this time because I don't have someone I'm playing with. And here we see the Toads and here come the Koopalings. The Koopalings are actually brought back in Super Mario Bros. Wii after taking a long hiatus. If you really want to get technical, they were also in Super Mario, Mario Luigi Superstar Saga, sorry. They were optional, well not optional, there were mini bosses in that game later on in the game. Get thrown into a tree, which introduces the new power-up for New Super Mario Bros. U. I apologize again in advance. This is semi-blind. I've not played this game since it released in November of 2012. As far as I remember. I may have played it once or twice here and there, but nothing major. And like Super Mario 3D World, this game has hidden collectibles in each of the worlds. Crazy Animator, are you still there? I apologize, my mic was off when I first started. I hope you're doing well. Showing off, but yes, the Koopalings, as far as I know, they were left out of the game ever since Super Mario World, if I recall correctly. And then with Super Mario Bros. Wii, they were brought back. This is the third game. Oops. That wasn't very smart of me. This is the third game in the new Super Mario Bros. Series. The first one was on the Nintendo DS and kind of started the thing. It was a brand new old style Mario game. Okay. But basically, this is a game in the style of the old school Mario games. which kind of stopped with Yoshi's Island. Okay, go on. And you can do this kind of twirl move, which gives you a little bit extra distance. Now this game did receive an expansion pack, which was the first expansion pack in Mario history, if I recall correctly. Which is not including Super Mario Bros. 2, the Japanese version, which might as well have been an expansion pack to Super Mario Bros. 1, just with harder levels. It's been a little bit. I'm used to Super Mario 3D World's controls. Now, if you like this style of gameplay, you can get Mario Maker, which is available on the Wii U and the 3DS. Unlike New Super Mario Bros. Super Mario 3D World, we do not get backup power-ups. So basically, if you mess up, you get hit. That's kind of that. But this one's definitely fun. There's also New Super Mario Bros. DS, which is available on the DS, and they actually brought it back as a virtual console game for the Wii U. Personally, I prefer it on the DS, just because you're forced to use the gamepad, which is a little awkward. It's understandable in a way, because you have to use the touchscreen. But there's also New Super Mario Bros. Wii, which was the second game in the series. It's also the first one on a home console. And it also introduced synchronous multiplayer, something that had never been in the series before then. Something that was touted since the Super Mario Bros. 2 days. The Super Mario Bros. 2 prototype actually featured synchronous multiplayer. It was something that Nintendo had been pushing for a long, long time. It was never really able to get until then. Super Mario 64 was also supposed to have it. This is why Luigi is not in that game, because that... Actually, sorry, it was Super Mario 64 2 that was supposed to have it. This game also has boost mode, which basically you can use the gamepad and you can help yourself by adding platforms and things. So like, for example, let's say I lost a power-up that I need to get to the top of the stage. I can use boost mode to jump up there and get something by creating temporary platforms. And that might be something that we play on stream soon too. Mario Maker, that would be awesome. I do really like that game. If you can call it that, it's more of a tool, but it does have game elements to it. I'm gonna are pre-made levels in Mario Maker that you can play. Okay, so I missed the second one. I guess I'll come back. There's also New Super Mario Bros. 2 on the 3DS, which, interestingly enough, focuses on coins. So there's tons of coins to collect, and there's tons of things to find. It's a really fun game, but I don't know. After Wii, I kind of got a little... I felt like they were getting a little samey. Okay, let's go back and see if we can find that second one. Now, it's interesting, I don't know if you guys watch Double D's channel. He's a friend of mine. We're really good friends. He was, the best man at my wedding. He does daily live streams of Overwatch. Not necessarily just Overwatch. He does do some other stuff, like he did do retro Blizzard games at one point. Predominantly, though, he's an Overwatch gamer. It's quite interesting to watch this stuff, so I really recommend checking it out. I have a link to his channel on every live stream that I do. So, just click that little eye up in the corner if you want to check it out. There's a link to his video up there. Or at least his channel. Long story short, typically I'll pop in, say hey, what's going on, while he's live streaming. So I'm in there, and I actually got recognized in chat as the Mario guy. I thought that was actually really cool. I mean, I'll take it. I'll be recognized as the Mario guy. It's kind of cool. I like it a lot. But I also want to impart that I'm not just a Mario gamer. True, I have covered most of the series on my YouTube channel, whether it's this one or my main channel, Jerry Martin Gaming. And you can get to that by going to youtube.com/c/JerryMartinGaming. There's also a link to it on this channel. And on that channel, I actually play through all of the early Mario games up till Super Mario 64. I have complete 100% walkthroughs of every game up till then. Maybe this is it. But my main channel does have obscure ones too, like the arcade game Super Mario Versus, which is a mashup between Super Mario Bros. 2, the Japanese version, and Super Mario Bros. 1. And an interesting note, they also changed the controls to flipping. I also have All Night Nippon Super Mario Bros., which is a special version released only as part of a radio promo featured microphones and various DJs, and it was kind of a mix between some new levels and some Super Mario Bros. 2 levels. And I also have the Famicom, NES, and Super NES games. All of them except Super Mario Bros. 3, which I have not released yet. Right now I'm currently walking on Super Nintendo working on Super Nintendo Classic games to try and bring you guys before that release on September 29th. I don't do just Mario games there. I have done Myst. I've done the entire 5 episodes of Strong Bad's Cool Game for Attractive People. I've done Mario's Missing. I've done Contra 1, 2, Contra, Super Contra, Contra Force, and now recently Contra 3, as well as Operation C. I've done a lot of the Double Dragon videos. In fact, I've covered over 120 video games in their entirety on my main channel, Jerry Martin Gaming. My most popular ones seem to be the Mega Man series, which I've actually completed all 10 games plus Mega Man at Base on the channel, plus all 5 Game Boy games in their entirety. So feel free to check that out if you like Mega Man. And my Mario's Missing seems to be very popular as well. My Dragon Power, the first Dragon Ball game on consoles, and the only one that was released to the US until Dragon Ball GT Final Bout 1996, even though they tried to remove all the Dragon Ball characters from it. I also did a, believe it or not, Little Mermaid walkthrough. I have walkthroughs for several versions of Little Mermaid on my channel. And those, for some reason, are very popular. I don't know if it's because there's very scant coverage on YouTube, or people are pulling it up when they search Little Mermaid, I'm not sure. I'm not gonna complain, I really appreciate people watching the videos and leaving feedback. But yes, as I stated, I'm currently working on Super Nintendo Classic version walkthroughs. I have 12 of the 21 games currently available on the walkthrough. I'm actually close to completing Star Fox. I have the Contra 3 walkthrough, I have Donkey Kong Country, I have Super Mario World as well as Super Mario World 2, I have Super Metroid, I have Super Mario Kart, I'm trying to remember what else I've covered. I did Super Castlevania 4, and I did both normal and hard on that one. I only have a few left. I have both Star Fox games to do. I have
Mario number one.
Final Fantasy VI, Earthbound, Secret of Mana, Street Fighter, Kirby, Kirby's Dream Course. I believe that's it. Not 100%. Okay, did I accidentally turn those off?
What? Why not?
Let's save. Show spoilers.
What? What?
Okay. Well, anyway. We might as well document some of this Miiverse before it shuts down. Which is rumored to happen soon. I've not been on the Wii U in a little bit. I've been somewhat busy with work. Staff shortages. I've actually put in a lot of overtime this week, so Yoshi, which is that? He was not available in Super Mario 3D World, as far as I know. Sure though, I remember that. No, for sure, Mr. Yoshi was not available in Galaxy 1, but he was brought back in Galaxy 2. He was also in Sunshine, which I like a lot. Well, I didn't, but I did. No, come back. Another really cool YouTube, you know, group of YouTubers. They really don't need my advertising because they're way big, they're a lot bigger than me. But I don't know if you guys watch Pat Country. But he does a podcast with Ian called Completely Unnecessary Podcast, which they talk about gaming news and various other news. Some wrestling news, some movie news. And he also does Pat DNA's punk videos. And they're very avid about retro gaming, which I can honestly say is awesome. I feel the same way. Maybe not to the same extent as them. I'm not. NES guidebook, which reviews every single NES game, at least in some way, shape, or form. Yeah, I think I missed the last one, guys. I did. Welcome back. I'm pretty sure it was up there, but I couldn't get back up there. Do have a lot of first-hand knowledge about retro gaming. I'm sorry, first-hand knowledge. No, a lot of knowledge about retro gaming, retro history, and the various, you know, the community that goes into this. And they make a lot of great points on their channel. I don't 100% agree with them on everything, but there are a lot of great points that they make. Good example is recently, like a month or two ago, they were talking about how retro gaming is becoming more about collecting and the value of collecting than about playing retro games, which is sad. And that's true. I mean, if you think about it, lots of NES collectors nowadays, how many of them have actually played the games that they love? How many are just using them to kind of just sit on their fancy shelves so they can look at it? There's another YouTuber, I can't remember his name, but he would talk about, you know, you have to open boxes, no sealed boxes on them. Sealed NES copy of a game that's somewhat common. Do you really want to break history by, you know, opening that when you can just get an unsealed copy? And in that instance, I can understand, but like, for example, like if you have a brand new or an old copy of a Sega Genesis game, I'll just sit on the shelf. Hey Double D, welcome to the stream. Thanks for coming by. It's been a while since I've seen you.
It's
been a while since I really screened last week. Nobody checked that one out. Don't die, that's against the rules. Yeah. That would be true. I was trying to give them a shout out. Since Double D is here in the channel, you can actually click on his name in chat. Direct you right to his channel. He does live streams every morning. He does do Overwatch. Last time he came over, he gave me a really cool NES Advantage controller, which I will definitely be using on some of my retro videos. So stay tuned for those. I just haven't gotten around to it because I've been doing Super Nintendo videos, mainly for the Super Nintendo Classic coming out. But he also helped me try and set up my Overwatch. Because my Overwatch is kind of funky. I don't know if my computer can necessarily handle it very well. Every time I try, it gets either really blurry and works fine, or it gets really sharp and don't. Does that work? Well, thank you, Double D. But yes, definitely check out Double D's channel at some point. Every time I live stream, there is a little box in the top right corner, a little eye. If you click on that, it'll bring up three cards. It'll show you my Super Mario 3D World videos, which I have now completed for the most part. There's also a link to Double D's channel directly in that. So every time I live stream, you can click on that little info, get the card, and it'll take you directly to Double D's live stream. Or, since Double D is in chat, you can just click on his name right now. Either way, check out that video, his channel. Every morning, he does Overwatch. I know we are planning to play Overwatch together, but he's kind of like several leagues above me in that game. you know, he's all knowledgeable of various tactics and team strategies, and I'm not even aware of who half the teammates are. Not only that, but my copy, like I said, last time Double D came over, he tried to help me set it up so that Overwatch didn't run so odd. So I think we both got it at a point where it's not terrible. It's just not amazing looking. And I'm not sure how that will change. I don't know, Double D, that's Spanish. Crazy Animator is German. Oh yeah, I broke the rules. Yeah, I've been working a ton of 4 a.m. shifts, which means getting up at 3 a.m. So, I've been quite tired, so I apologize. That's one reason I haven't been streaming as much lately. Another is that I've been working on walkthroughs for several Super Nintendo Classic games. Contra 3, I just finished, I put out a little while ago. I may need to be Ethernet'd or need more RAM. Is it choppy again? Or are you just saying that because of the Overwatch problems? Double D. And the problem is my modem is clear on the other side of the house, so it'd be a little tough to Ethernet it in. Though it would be awesome. Okay, so. Okay, I'll take that. You know, it's interesting, last week... Oh, the Overwatch problems, I think going over Wi-Fi is the biggest thing. Yeah, that could have a big impact on it, Double D, yes. I think once things... Yoshi. Okay, I guess he'll follow me for food. I think we should probably look into it. But at the moment, it's not a huge pressing issue. Since I also have Overwatch for PS4, so if I need to, I can stream it from there. Got him on sale. Oh, okay. Works for me. But yes, Overwatch was on sale for its anniversary. Watching the net right now. So weird seeing old tech versus the new stuff. Or old tech is new stuff. Yeah. I'm not aware of that. I've not seen it. Double D. But I know what you're talking about. I did see a internet video a while ago of explaining how to use 90s internet. Which, I know a lot of younger people here probably don't remember that, but oh god. There's a little bit of a task to get on the internet back in the 90s. Interesting story. Double D and I used to play RuneScape. I know we talked about this in a previous stream. But here's the point I was kind of gonna make is, you know, we're playing through it, we're enjoying it. But back in the 90s, there's this RuneScape Classic, so this was still a 2D game, you know. I died. So we were really choppy, like trying to walk on dial-up was like, you know, we were probably getting like maybe 6 frames a second. It was really bad. Why'd I do that? I did it early. Boost mode, okay. I didn't think about that. So we were getting really bad reception, so Double D and I would play together. It just so happened that a friend of mine had upgraded to broadband. We didn't quite have it yet, but for some reason he was still using He's still paying for the dial-up. So he let me use his account, and I would use it to play RuneScape with Double D, so that we can have the two different internet, you know, and eventually, my parents started springing for broadband, and that was like night and day. Like, it was just like eyes wide open, kind of. And suddenly our characters were moving really quick. Suddenly we weren't getting beaten when we raced over to the mine spot. Because back then, it used to be one mine spot, and the first person who clicked it got it. I don't know if they changed that since then. Probably, but and back in the I don't know why I'm going for this. I might just come back to this one. Oh, there's Yoshi. So, like, we would always click on the mine to try and get ore. But we'd always get beaten because we were slow. We didn't have random pickaxes. Why not do that? Some people would always come back and beat us to the punch. And once we had broadband, nobody beat us to the punch. And Double D, I remember Double D and I would always argue over who got the broadband. Because, you know, summer break, we're playing. We're up till 4 in the morning. Sometimes later. And the majority of our night was usually spent on RuneScape because we could play it together. And funnily enough, it was mainly we had like a cycle where we'd mine, take the ore back to town, smith, sell the smith, get gold. Using that technique, I actually ended up getting a rune pickaxe. I don't know if Double D knows this, but I was actually in the RuneScape Hall of Fame for a little while, which is basically a way of them saying, hey, these are the top 100 players, and this particular skill. And so, I actually got in the Hall of Fame for mining, because I think I got level 83 mining, got exclusive. They have a exclusive mining club too, which you can only get into if you have, it's like, I think it was level 69 at the time. But this is back in the day, and I'm pretty sure, you know, nowadays, pretty much anybody has maxed out mining. I've not played RuneScape in well over 10 years. I remember Double D actually calling me one time when I was living with my ex and told me, hey, I've gotten back into Minecraft, let's play together. We play for a little while, but no, Double D, I was not kidding. I actually was in the Minecraft, I'm sorry, not Minecraft, RuneScape Hall of Fame for mining. I guarantee I'm not anymore, if they even have a mining Hall of Fame. But it was basically like a leaderboard, because I would always sit there and I'd just mine. But this was back in like 2005, 2006 maybe. Maybe even 2004. It would be interesting. I know Double D revisited America's Army, which is one that we played in the past, simply because we were really into FPS games back in the day. Double D still is, but it would be interesting if we did a double live stream going back into RuneScape to see what it's like, what it's changed, etc., etc. Now, Double D, I'm not sure if you are interested. Perhaps a little later on, maybe in a half hour or so, we could do a Jackbox live stream. I could probably call Heather and see if she wants to play. I know she's been hounding me lately. We haven't played Jackbox in probably a month, I want to say. And so she really wants to play it. Because I kind of focused on Mario ever since I got the Elgato. But if you would like to play, let me know. It's going to happen now. That'd be fun. Sweet. I look forward to that. That would be fun to go back and play with. RuneScape with you. I know there are a lot of successful RuneScape streamers. That would be a really fun, interesting. Okay, got a... Nope, that was dead. You can play, but you won't be able to go live and watch the stream, though. Okay, well, that's fine. That was just kind of floating the idea out there, because I know Heather has been asking me recently. If we could play that game. I figured I typically live stream on Fridays around 5. But that is way more fun to live stream. I know on one of your chats, someone was asking if there's something we could play together, so I'm trying to remember who that was and if it would be possible to send them an invite. Okay. Well, it kind of looks like at the moment nobody's besides you is watching this stream. I can always switch over real quick. Yeah, so we do a few more of those. Mario is one of those games I really like playing. Now, Double D, if you want to troll on Mario, this one's definitely the better Mario to do so in. I missed one. If you guys have not seen that, Double D played Super Mario 3D World with me and my wife. The battery is dying. Basically, after a certain point, Double D decides to work against the team instead of for the team. It was pretty funny. Maybe I should wait until your phone's got a little bit of a charge, Double D, because I don't know how playing Jackbox and watching the stream will go as far as your battery. Where's he at? I recently picked up a few movies lately, because I was watching, I've been watching kind of American Dad, because that was the one Seth MacFarlane animated comedy that I have not seen all the way till the end. So, I ended up, you know, kind of thinking about stuff. I ended up rewatching a lot of The Office. I watched that. I usually get an urge to watch The Office every year or so. And I'll usually, because I have all of it on DVD, I usually watch through, binge watch a lot of it. But, that's one show that I can watch over and over and over. The Office just has like a kind of surreal sense of humor. I just find hilarious. And one thing I really like about it was not only the characters, but the character growth. You know, like every episode counts. You know, it's not like some episodes where it's like, okay, they did this, the next episode nobody remembers that. Like, there might be one episode where... good example. There's one episode where Dwight mentions, I want that chair. He sees a chair, he wants that chair. And... three seasons, four seasons later, it's kind of innocuous, you kind of forget about it, but he's sitting in that chair. You know, and, or they talk about, you know, like there's one episode where a girl goes in and she's selling purses. It's, you know, later on they talk about the girl. She pops up every now and again. That's one reason I like The Office. Okay, I'm not gonna do that again. I'm gonna have to look up how to get that one. But I'll have to wait. But I ended up buying Terminator 4-pack. I've seen Terminators 1 and 2. Believe it or not, I only saw them for the first time roughly 10 years ago. I was at work and I was talking to a guy about movies, and he's mentioning movies that he likes. He has to say, you know, I really love the Terminator series, and I had to tell him, I hate to break this to you, but I've never seen any of the Terminators. And he kind of gave me a double take look, and he's like, are you joking? You can't be serious. Who hasn't seen Terminator? But I had explained, no, sorry, man, I'm not joking. So he ends up, he gives me a VHS copy of Terminator. So I watched Terminator on VHS, and he lent me his copy of 2 on DVD. And, you know, funny enough, he actually came up to me and he started like a movie club. He's like, alright, I can't trust that you haven't seen more movies, so I'm gonna make a list, you're gonna have to watch these movies. Yeah, I laugh now, but Terminator 1 and 2 are great. I've never seen 3 or 4. I have 5. I've not seen it yet. I got it in the, like, the bargain bin. Like, $3 movie bin. So I don't have super high hopes for it, but it did look interesting. For $3, why not? Even if it's terrible, it's almost the same price as a Redbox rental. There's one other one. There are a lot of movies that I have to watch still. Have to see Alien. I had an opportunity to watch that one. That was actually at my graduation party. Some guy brought it up. It was too loud, Alien. But there are other things going on that... they were mainly playing Counter-Strike. That and, this is an interesting story, so... growing up, there were these two guys. They were both awesome guys, you know. Yeah. But they were really close. And we always used to tease them about being more than friends. And they'd always deny, oh, we're not gay, blah, 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 blah. And that would cause us to tease them even more.
Yeah.
And so I invited both of them to the graduation party that I had. And, you know, we had it at my friend's, my friend's mom owned kind of like a gaming center, or she knew people that owned a gaming center or something like that. And so she somehow got it the okay to have an overnight LAN gaming center there, play LAN games. I don't believe Double D was at that one. I think it was a different one. But, because I know I had a second one there, like a week later, and I know for sure that Double D was there, and I believe his brother was there too. But, long story short, my friend's mom had brought over these inflatable mattresses. There are only two of them, though. One was a queen size, and one was a twin size. So I pretty much said, you know what, guys, fight it out. I can pull an all-nighter. I don't need a bed. And we had, I want to say, four people there, or five people. But one second, let me see what just got sent. Oh, Double D just texted me. Text or message when you want to get on Jackbox. Sure, I will let you know. Anyway, so, I kind of was just like, whatever, fight it out amongst yourselves, I don't care.
Mario time.
And we're kind of playing games, and there's a TV there that they used for console games, but they had a, like a VCR kind of, I think there was even a DVD player on it, but I'm not 100%, I don't remember. But, yeah, one of the guys brought over Alien, or Aliens, I'm not sure which one it was. Like I said, I've never seen either of those. So. Not sure which one it was. Long story short, they put out the mattress. And, friend number one goes, hey, you know, I'm kind of tired. Wake me up when, wake me up when the booms are on. I said, really, dude, like, I know when that is. He said, oh, come on, just. So he fell asleep in the, mattress. I guess that's not it. Okay, wall jump off to him. Friend number two says, okay, I'm tired, I'm going to bed. Doesn't tell anyone. Me and friend number three pulling all night, I just saw. they could be like, okay, you can have the bed, whatever. At 6 in the morning, when the light starts to get, you know, come up, we look over and see friend number one and friend number two in the queen bed together. The best part is both of them are horrified. Like they couldn't believe what just happened. That only led to further allegations, and we were joking around about it. But of course, that's another story. Both swear that the other was, you know, the one who did it. They both swore that, oh, you know, I wouldn't have done that. I didn't do that. You know, we both kind of are like, well, what do you mean? One of you had to do it. It's not like you were sleepwalking. Anyway, that was a funny story. I know I kind of butchered it, kind of ran off for a little while, but I'm glad. Unequivocally cool about having your own computer there, shared lobby. You know, you're all together in the same room, kind of split-screening with your off-screen, your own monitor, everything. You just don't get that same feeling online. Unfortunately. Like, I remember playing Return to Castle Wolfenstein and Quake 3, as well as EverQuest and LAN parties. Those were interesting. The most interesting thing I think we saw, for some reason, we were playing Return to Castle, we were playing Quake 3, and then one of our friends decided to be stupid and not join Quake 3. They wanted to play Return to Castle Wolfenstein. So there was a little argument. He kind of just said, screw it, I'm creating a lobby. Anybody wants to play Castle Wolfenstein, play with me. Anybody wants to play Quake 3, then join up on Quake 3. Kind of everybody joined up on Quake 3. Not to spite anyone. It's just more of a, dude, why are you going against the crowd? Long story short, because they're using, I think, the same engine or similar engines, Quake 3 found Castle Wolfenstein game. I remember everyone was like, whoa, you know, That's nuts. No way. Several people tried to join it and their games froze. I know, a lot of people have asked me in the past why I still play retro games. And my answer has always been because retro games are fun. But the truth of the matter is, it's a bit of nostalgia involved in it. Now, I'd be lying if I didn't say I played Mario World because, oh, Mario World is awesome. I remember it from being a kid. But truthfully, I mean, even if you didn't play Mario World as a kid, you could still pick up Mario World and go, man, what a fantastic game. That and there seems to be kind of like a lot of confusion over retro games. A lot of retro games require some strategic thinking. Are very cryptic and make you play the game to understand it. A lot of people don't. Of course, back in the day, this was because it was supplemented with instruction manuals. They expected you to actually go out, read the instruction manual that came with it. Like, I remember Civ 3 came with an actual, like, book. Like, no joke, it was just, like, 200 pages long or something. And then granted, the Civilization series is really complex. It is really fun. If you have not tried Civilization, I highly, highly, highly recommend you try it. But just be prepared to get lost in it for hours. Of course, if you're not into 4X strategy games, you're not going to enjoy it. But that goes without saying. I think this will be the last level that I'm gonna do before we switch to Jackbox. But it may be a little bit of a delay. I have to call up my sister Heather. Make sure her and her family are down, because there are only a few games that Double D and I can play together by ourselves. We did Gespionage, we did Fury Murder Party together. And unfortunately, we can't do You Don't Know Jack together, which would be a very, very interesting one to do. I would really much like to do that, simply because You Don't Know Jack is, it's basically a quiz show. It's like, who wants to be a millionaire with attitude? But because of the way the Jackbox Party Pack worked, the first one at least, they did not build with streaming intended. So, if I were to play that, there would be a good 2-minute delay. Well, not 2 minutes necessarily, it'd be 30-second delay to double the. And by that point, whatever we're playing is gone. Especially on the Jak attack, which you need to quick tap as quick as you can. So if you're not physically here, there's no point in playing it because the person who is here will dominate, even if they don't know the answer. Okay, guys, thanks for checking it out. Double D, I will text you in a minute. I don't know if you're still watching, but I will text you as soon as I get a hold of Heather and see if she wants to play. For the rest of you, thank you guys for watching. I'll be back with Jakbox in just, hopefully within the next 20 to 30 minutes. Hopefully it does not take that long to get a hold of her. Alright, I will see you guys soon. We will be playing this again shortly.